Hey everyone, I hope you're all doing well. I want to say first and foremost, thank you for stopping by and watching the video. Today's video is going to be, you know, a lot more informal, but I wanted to make this because I think it's important. And it's basically going to be me just giving you a brief summary, I guess, or just some insight as to how I got to where I am now. I think it's going to give you a lot of the lessons. I'm also going to talk about the lessons I learned along the way that have helped me become who I am. Now, I'm not saying that you should strive to be who I am, but in terms of fitness and in terms of the mentality you need to achieve certain things, I've learned a lot over the years, and it wasn't always this way. I wasn't always driven, I wasn't a hard worker, all these things. So I want to talk about that because I've also found a lot of others that resonate with this message, okay? So with that said, I'm going to break down some of my past, where I came from, my transformation, how it led to where I am, some lessons that I took away, as well as my vision for the future, my vision for the channel, etc. Okay, so with that said, let's go ahead and get started. One thing that nobody's gonna know about me on this channel, because I haven't spoken much about it, is my past. I actually started working out. Currently, I'm 24 years old. I'm actually turning 25 in September, September 24th. And I started working out when I was 14 years old, okay? Now, the reason I started working out wasn't the reason I feel like maybe a lot of people do. For me, I was kind of thrown into, I wanted to, but I was thrown into this varsity football team of all these massive 12th graders when I was in grade 9, being one of the only 9th graders on the team, at least the one that stuck to it through the end. I remember I had never played football before. I had played hockey, I had played physical contact sports, but not to this degree, and it was a wake-up call. I had these massive guys just trucking me over to the point where I probably got concussions. My head was pounding, I was seeing stars, and I remember taking a seat one day, again, 14 years old, and I thought, okay, if I want to compete, because I ain't gonna fucking quit, but if I want to compete, I got to start working out. And at the time, I had a bench press in my basement and some of those plastic, you know, those colored plastic dumbbells. So from that point forward, something triggered where I said, okay, that's it. I remember sitting on the side thinking, that's it. I need to start working out to compete with these guys. They were 10 times bigger, stronger, faster, everything. I was a scrawny little 9th grader, okay? I didn't want to get my head pounded in the sand anymore. So I started working out by just going downstairs every day when I came home from high school. I went downstairs and I started bench pressing and I started curling. That was all I knew what to do. I only thought that these were the two functions that people do when they work out. I had no idea about anything else. And that's how it started. It wasn't to get girls. It wasn't because I got bullied. On the contrary, what happened was over those first 4 years or so, from 14 to 18, I was really caught up in a bad scene. I was simply just a product of hanging out with the wrong people. And I was going down the wrong path. I was drinking alcohol obsessively, like every single weekend, multiple times a weekend, binge drinking to the point of passing out, throwing up, all these things, right? I was smoking weed every single day, multiple times a day, for 4, 5, 6 years, okay? So my habits weren't the best, and this is why I barely gained any weight, because I didn't take my nutrition seriously. But I gained some strength because I was working out, and a lot of the people on the football team, by the time I got to grade 11, 12, had not been working out as much as me. So though I was skinny, I had a lot of power and whatnot. Great. So what happens is, ages 19, 20, I'm in college now. And in college, I still haven't taken my fitness that seriously. However, what happened was I started realizing, okay, I'm not seeing the results I want to see in fitness, okay? Now, again, 5 years later, I say, look, I want to gain some weight. I want to gain some muscle. And so that's when I started bulking and taking things seriously. I started doubling up. That's when I started tracking my calories for the first time. And this is why the main thing I always preach is to track your calories, because the first time I tracked my calories was the biggest eye-opener and ultimately began the ultimate transformation of my life. So I started taking things more seriously, and what I started doing with the drinking and whatnot, because a lot of people out there feel like they're held back because, oh, but you know, how am I, all my friends drink, all my friends eat like crap, all these things. And I understand that the peer pressure is tough when you're younger. But ultimately, here's the thing. We try so hard to fit in with a group of people or to fit in with others, right? Because we think that that's gonna make them respect us more or like us more. that kind of stuff. But the truth of the matter is this. We respect, we look up to, and we admire those who stand alone. So in high school, the person that stood alone, that didn't do what everybody else wanted, that did what they wanted to, we end up admiring them. We end up looking up to them, given that they're doing something productive with their life. They're not just a loser. So unfortunately, if you're caught in this rat race of trying to fit in with somebody, and this is one of the first lessons I learned, you're trying to fit in with a group of people, you're gonna have to give up something else that maybe you truly want inside. Maybe you know that you deserve to be in better shape. You know that you could be in better shape. You know that you want to be in better shape. But when I did that, guess what? I went from drinking multiple times a weekend, every weekend binge drinking, to suddenly thinking, you know what? I think I want to stop this whole lifestyle of partying and all that. I had experienced so many unbelievable things, experiences, and all this crazy shit by that time, that to me, I was like, you know, everything's starting to kind of feel the same. Like, I get it, you know, eventually it gets kind of boring, right? So I wanted something new. I wanted a new challenge. And so I stopped drinking as much. Some days I would go out and I would choose to be the designated driver, and I would not drink and I would drive. And I remember cutting out the weed. I'm not coming out tonight. No, I'm not coming out tonight. And don't get me wrong, I got judged and criticized quite a bit throughout this period of my life, but it didn't matter. It literally didn't matter, and it didn't faze me at all. It was a little annoying when I'm there. No, I'm not drinking. Ah, come on, you pussy, and this, that. You know how it is with young guys, right? And it didn't faze me because I knew what I wanted. Something clicked. I had a series of epiphanies where I saw my life flash before my eyes, and I realized, hey, if I keep this up, the last 5 years flew by. If I keep this up for another five, it's going to fly by like that. It's going to fly by like that. I'm 30, I'm 40, I'm 50, and I'm nowhere. That's all I needed. A few of those epiphanies, a few realizations, and I started switching my habits, okay? Then I started getting more serious about it. I started actually, I knew a lot because I was researching and all that, but I really started diving deep at this point. So I was around 18, 19, I was diving deep into nutrition, diving deep into working out, and I realized, okay, I decided to go to school for fitness and health promotion, which was an amazing program. Learned a lot, met tons of amazing people. Some of my best friends of all time I've met there. But on top of that, I just started taking things more seriously. I was still drinking, but every time I would get drunk, and I just felt like I shouldn't be doing this. Needless to say, a few years down the line, I finally got to a point, just fast forward through a bunch of stuff that happened. I'm at the point now where I haven't drank alcohol in a very long time, okay? I had a few drinks maybe the other night, not enough to get me a buzz, nothing like that. That's the last time I can remember drinking that much in probably a year. And the reason why is because once you start making changes in the right direction, when it comes to your health and fitness primarily, you're gonna notice some things, at least I did. Changes in energy, changes in mood, hormone regulation, so you're able to control yourself better. You don't feel stress as much, you don't feel anger as much. You start becoming more driven, you start having more energy when you wake up in the morning, more purpose. You start thinking, okay, what can I use all this extra energy for? What else can I do with my life? So one of the biggest lessons I learned was it's very understated or underappreciated or underestimated how powerful being in the best shape of your life really is. Taking your nutrition seriously, and more importantly, I learned consistency. True consistency was not, I used to work out for a couple months, fall off for a couple months. I'd work out for 5 days a week for a few weeks, 2 days a week, sparsely, randomly here and there. I would go to the gym, but I wasn't ready, or I just ate, so it felt like crap, or I didn't eat all day, or whatever, right? When I started having a routine consistently, right, it really changed the game for me. All these things culminated and combined into basically, imagine a snowball rolling down a hill. It gets bigger and bigger and bigger. This is what happens when you take care of your health and fitness. That's the biggest lesson I learned, is that your health and fitness is the cornerstone to your success and your happiness in every area of your life. It might sound cheesy and corny, but it just doesn't get any more real than that. And so, that's where I am today. I've gone from somebody who smoked weed 4, 5, 6 times a day every single day. I drank alcohol to an extreme amount. I did bad things that there's no need to talk about. I did things that I'm not necessarily proud of, but I'm happy that I went through this time. I'm also lucky that I didn't end up in a worse situation, as I feel like in some cases I should have. And that might be a topic for another video. If you guys are interested in knowing that, just, you know, comment below. Maybe I'll make one on that. But the point is I was going down a dark path, a very dark path. I was going to be nobody. I was doing terrible in school. I didn't go to university because I was not able to. They would not accept me. To now going to somebody who people are always reaching out to, right? And I'm not saying this to brag. I'm not famous. I'm none of that. But I inspire. I aim to inspire people. I aim to change people's lives. And people recognize that, and they come to me for questions, answers. I get messages every single day telling me how I've changed this person's life or I've helped this person do this. And it's really a whole different life, right? And recreating yourself starts with your health and fitness. Because when you start taking that seriously, it will compound, it will translate to every other area of your life so unfathomably better. It's gonna make it so much better that you will excel in everything, right? Your drive's gonna go up, your passion's gonna go up, your intelligence is gonna go up. I started reading books all of a sudden. I didn't read a book in 8, 9, 10 years. I've read 100, 200 books in the last 2 years. The mastery of your personal fitness. This is the ultimate lesson I learned. The mastery of your personal fitness is the beginning of your mastery to anything else you want in life. Because the concepts that apply to getting in the best shape you ever can applies to achievement in anything. Some of those things are this. One is time. It takes you a lot longer than you think. When I was 16, I thought, oh my God, just imagine when I'm in grade 12, or when I was whatever, grade 9, I was like, imagine when I'm in grade 12, I'm gonna look like this guy on the cover of the magazine. Obviously it didn't happen, I'm still not there. But every year, I thought, oh, just wait till I'm 25. I'm almost 25 now, I'm not nearly where I wanna be. Obviously it's part of the process, but always understand it's gonna take longer than you think. Everybody's in the short-term mindset. We've got the phones, right? Everybody, we want instant pleasure. Fitness is all about delayed gratification. It's all about sacrificing. When I look at my diet, I look at it as a test. Can I sacrifice now for a better tomorrow? And if you can, and ultimately, that's how you're gonna get to the shape you wanna get to. That's how you're gonna get consistent with your diet. You have to sacrifice today for a better tomorrow, okay? But you'll enjoy the process as you do it because you'll get better and better. And those are some of the lessons I learned. My vision now is to take everything I've learned and what I keep learning and trying to shift the way the world is, trying to make a dent, an impact on this planet and change the way humanity views and experiences their health and fitness, how they go about it, how they improve it. Because obviously we know the world is on a decline right now when it comes to health and fitness and issues and all that. The life expectancy average, whatever, has raised so much, but just imagine with all the issues we have how much further it could go. How much better of a place the world would be if they experienced what I experience on a daily basis. That's what I know. And everybody else that's in amazing shape, everybody else trying to do what I'm doing, they experience it as well. So my goal is to make a dent in this planet, ultimately in this universe, to change the lives of millions and millions of people, to begin to bend the trajectory of the world. Instead of going down, starts going up. That's the goal. That's the goal with the channel. That's the goal with my business. That's the goal of my life. So it came from somebody who was a nobody, if you ask anybody else, to making the change slowly over time, self-awareness, delayed gratification, get better every single day, take a step forward every day, right? Invest more in yourself. Stop caring what others think about you. And if I can do it, you can do it too. And that's what I'm here to tell you. Those are some of the lessons I learned. I know it's kind of all over the place. That's my vision. That's where I came from. That's how I changed. If you want more details about, you know, how I went about it or maybe some intricacies, just drop it in the comments below. I'll be happy to bring that to you, all right? I'm just not sure if this is something you guys are so interested in. So I figured I'd drop this video. So if you are interested in it, and let me know whatever else you'd like to see. Maybe more videos like this. I'd be happy to make them, like I said. Whatever is gonna help you out achieve the same transformation or a better one than I have. Because again, if I can, you can. and I hope you do. So that's it, guys. Thanks for watching the video. I really appreciate it as always. Please share it with your friends, anybody that you feel like needs to watch this, which is probably everybody. And share it with them. Don't forget to like, dislike if you want to get roasted by the kid. Share with your friends. Subscribe because I drop weekly fitness content. And yes, that's every damn week. See you in the next one. I'm out.